full disclosure, I can't absolutely guarantee that, but I can guarantee this is going to be the most amazing day of your life. Right, I better fill you in on what's going on and how.
Okay, good news, bad news time. I've been kidnapped. Not sure how, but I've been thrown to the edge of time and space. Luckily, there are bits and bobs of tech debris out here that I've grabbed. Managed to cobble together a very basic time-space visualizer so I can keep an eye on you. Actually, we can do better than this. Hold on, I'm shifting my...
Talk to you using local tech, and believe you me, I'll need to keep in touch because, sorry about this, you're the only one who can help me save the universe. And oh yeah, I'm the doctor. I'm sure you're the... itself is being hacked, wiped, degraded. This reality virus is corrupting the past, present, and future. Now, I need you to check out the washing machines. And when you do, please, don't freak out. Those creatures are hydrops. Vicious amphibians sometimes used as guards by races like the Stenza and Zygons. They're deadly carnivores with no table manners and a taste for human flesh. They shouldn't even be in this system. We can thank the reality virus for them showing up here. Right now, they're incubating, but that won't take long. Then they'll smash out of the machines, so you've got to get out of there sharpish. Looks like there's only one exit, through the back door in the manager's office. Be careful, and whatever you do...
Take the that's gotta be a part of it. Four, take the get in there. That'll be it. Try to open the safe using the two sets of numbers you found. Oh, I love my sonic screwdriver, so don't lose it. Actually, I'll show you a nifty little trick to keep it safe when you're not using it. Super handy that. Grab the sonic gun. Word of warning, the hydrox are on the verge of breaking out, so you better get a move on. You need to unlock the door using the sonic. Thanks. Look, that door won't hold the hydrox for long. We've got lovely. Now plonk it on the workbench next to sonic the carb on it. That might open it so you can see if there's anything in there that could help. A battery! Put that car battery on the workbench. Right, use the sonic on them. That's it. Signal at maximum power. Oh, you are gonna love this bit.
Virus. Told you it was going to be amazing. But newsflash, now we've got to get on and somehow save all of creation. Right? This is going to be fun. welcome aboard. Come in then, make yourself at home. Wish I had time to give you a guided tour, but we're up against it. We can't get distracted. So, here's the skinny. Do people still say here's the skinny? What actually is the skinny? Never understood it, to be honest with you. I mean, sorry, easily distracted. Big picture. I'm marooned at the end of time and space. I have to cobble together a vortex manipulator to get back to where I should be. That way, I can deal with the reality virus and whoever created it. But I need three pieces of Zyton to power the manipulator through the time vortex. Getting the Zyton is where you come in. And if you want a reminder of what's at stake, take a look behind you. That's what's at stake. Your world and countless others. So you've got to find those three pieces of Zyton. And let's get one thing absolutely straight. One very important thing. We are so calling them time crystals from now on, because that sounds way cooler. The hologram's going to be patchy from now on. I'm guessing it's the reality virus messing with the visuals. Okay, get back to the console and I'll tell you what needs to be done. The TARDIS has switched to autopilot mode. Don't take it personally, just doesn't know you yet. But there's some stuff autopilot doesn't cover. You have to locate the first time crystal yourself. That panel you can see is your interface with the TARDIS. Step up to it and I'll guide you through what you need to do. Ready? Okay, as a wise man once said, allons-y! Where and when the first time crystal is. This should help locate it. Oh, you're getting good at this. Not quite as fast as my PB, but you're knocking at the door. Well, you're approaching the porch. Driveway, cul-de-sac, whatever.
Is you. I can wait to see you again. Look, I've got to be quick because there's a time glitch, like, imminent. So just listen to me. You're on Lucian Mindbook. Everyone thinks everything is okay, but it's not. The glitch that's about to happen will change everything. The Slysters will have invaded this place, and we know it, the Tasmans. But you can't help. You have to help.
You were ever going to get around to asking. And if you want some free advice, I'd get the hell out of there, like 2-3. Because the Tasmas are hungry tonight.
Well, doesn't it?
Emergency life support system designed to protect the ship's crew. When the Slicers took over the craft and killed them, you couldn't accept that loss. You adopted the characteristics of a crew member, probably your favorite, and over the years you've come to fully believe in the construct you created. But Emma, I recognize you as an emergent new life form and promise to transfer you to a more appropriate system. In other words, I will get you out of there.
I failed to protect the original crew of this ship, but I will not lose you or your friend. My friend. Here's what I've learned from the ship's computers. The Slicers feed on attention, and without it, they devolve into Tasmans, mute, feral hunters banished from the Slicer community. They killed most of the ship's original crew. But now power's been restored.
They've set a course to power bomb a sun. The ship's drive unit will cause a supernova, and dozens of planets will be obliterated. As Leicester's plan on getting away using escape capsules.
Of course. The Leicesters know the Shadow Proclamation will hold them accountable, but they'll reckon being put on trial for genocide will give them all the attention they crave. Emma, I need you to change the ship's flight plan and unlock the time crystal we came here for. Can you help?
Oh, the Leicesters have locked me out of the system. Oh, but there's a manual override.
Right then, my human friend. You're up. We need to put Emma in the driving seat, so you've got to override those three control terminals. Charge them with the sonic. Brill, keep going.
Brilliant. I can access the time crystal and eject it from the unit. I've managed to transmit the TARDIS into the main body of the ship. Go to it! Now! Save yourself! There's no time to rescue me, but I've managed to change the Lucia Minor's course. She'll crash into the deserted planet, destroying the Leicesters and me. Now go!
Wow! I thought I had first dibs on dramatic entrances. Well, grab it then. Before you go, quickly, sonic the emergency life support system. The panel with the flashing lights. Quickly!
Goodbye!
That was a kindness. No, you haven't got much time to escape. Go through the door that just opened and get back to the TARDIS.
Artificial gravity systems are now failing. Onboard gravity now failing. Thank you for flying with the SS...
Well done, you! You've got us the first time crystal. We just need two more, then I can escape and save the universe from the reality virus. Sounds easy when you say it quickly, doesn't it? But you know what? You managed to get something else very important. When you zapped the controls, you downloaded Emma into the sonic screwdriver. I offered the Leicesters the same chance of escape, but they chose to go out in a blaze of... well, you can't really call it glory. Okay. We've got a second time crystal to get our mitts on. When you were on Lucia Minor, Medipods implanted a nanotranslator into your brain. You won't have felt a thing, and they're harmless. The TARDIS is going to transmit Emma's thoughts into the translator, so you'll be able to hear her wherever you are. All the knowledge she extracted from the ship's databanks is now in her memory. I reckon you and Emma are going to make a great team. At least I hope so. If you don't, it's end of the world time, so no pressure then.
I know this probably feels weird, me talking to you like this via the nanotranslator in your brain. I can talk to you, offer advice, process readings and data and stuff like that, but I can't help you in any physical sense. Soz. Activate the TARDIS when you're ready.
Time crystal is... oh, you know what? I think it's in the time cabinet of the late but unlamented Magnus Greel, which makes my spidey senses start to tingle big time. Let's take a closer look where we are. I can't guide you this time, I've got too much to do back here, but Emma will help you. Like I said, the TARDIS is going to patch her directly through to you. She should be able to track the time crystal, so get out there, find it, bring it back, and don't hang about. Evil and me go way back, and I can't put my finger on it, but somewhere out there, evil is waiting. Good luck.
Get a load of this. This place looks deserted. But I can sense something. I can't make sense of the readings I'm getting. Have a look around. Let's see what we can find out. A perfect fit. Wind it up and let's see if it still works.
Good evening, my friend. Allow me to introduce myself. I am Sir Manfred Grail, collector of objets d'art and singular ephemera. I know who you are. And your companion, Emma. Does that surprise you? It shouldn't. You have invaded my home before. Many times. I'm aware you seek the cabinet of Magnus Grail and the crystal within. You've done well to get this far, mon camarade de guerre. You are brave and resourceful. And so I'll give you one piece of crucial information and a warning. Although why I should is beyond me, as I cannot hope to profit from it. But this is vital. If you are to reach the cabinet, you must... special lift. Learn its mysteries, and it will take you to the crypts below my home. Here you will find the cabinet and the time crystal which it holds. Your prize. But every prize must have its perils. Where would be the fun if it was as easy as simply finding the cabinet? No, no, no. That wouldn't do at all. It is protected. That warning I promised you. The cabinet is guarded by my angels. Although I suspect that since the changes, they may no longer be my angels. I fear they are coming and will destroy me as they will surely destroy you too, my friend. My final warning, whatever you do, don't... No. No. No!
Manfred dead now. Manfred big fat boy, but angels still hungry. Angels still hungry.
Angels feast on you.
Angels feast on you.
Angels eat you. We're coming to get you. We're coming to get you. Cry baby bunting. Doctor's friends have gone a-hunting. On to fetch the precious stones. But the angels eat your bones.
You know what the scary thing is? The voices aren't coming from the phonograph anymore. Do me a favor. Give that crank on the phonograph another spin. And let's see what this room will look like when we've left. Well, we've got a swanky new room to explore. Hop to it. Whoa! Look at that flame. I think we're on the right track. flame didn't burn purple. It must be the wrong order. Whoa! Look at that flame. I think we're on the right track. Okay, and the next one. Sorry, Grail. It's for the good of the universe. Whoa, did not expect that. Let's follow it.
Free me. Use the flames.
What a creepy painting. Did that painting just move?
Set me free. Flames are key. Bring me home into the light.
Someone just opened it. You found it. Well played, Sherlock. You have in your hand a trionic lattice, also known as a time key. Put it in your pocket for now. I reckon it will come in handy later on. I guess we're getting in now. How about you leave me in the TARDIS for this one? The readings I'm getting are off the chart. Oh, the crypt is absolutely infested with angels. So just get to the cabinet. Open it using the time key. Grab the time crystal and get the hell out of it. And whatever you do, don't blink. Don't even blink. You did it! And I'm using the power of the signal crystal to get through to the Doctor. See if she can get the TARDIS to materialize inside the building, so we can vamoose before the angels figure out a way to follow us. It's the time crystal! Grab it before the angels decide you're a threat. Uh-oh. Looks like the generator is out. Suppose we're going to have to do this the old-fashioned way. Look, we can still get out of this place. Let's make a start by winding the crank on that generator unit, at the one on the wall up ahead. Hang on. Just a moment longer and the lift will open. You're safe. You've got the time crystal. Everything is going to be fine. I think. Well, that didn't last long, did it? According to the TARDIS database, weeping angels have a unique self-defense mechanism. Long story short, keep them in sight and we should be okay. Hang on! Just a moment longer and the lift will open. Thank you. maximum power. Let's get back here. Lift to reactivate. Keep your wits about you. Now, we're getting closer to the TARDIS. I can feel it. Good. Now, we just have to wait for the lift to reactivate. Keep your wits about you. So that's why the Weeping Angel in the painting gave us the key. It wasn't helping us. It wanted us down here, so we'd have to face these angels. You made it! Great! Now, let's get back to the TARDIS.
Whoa! I'm glad to be back. Things got pretty hectic back there. We make quite a good team, don't we?
What took you so long? While you've been sightseeing and taking it easy, I've been doing the donkey work and finding out what's behind the reality virus. First things first, though. I can detect a force is trying to fix us in a tractor beam. I'm not having that. I'm going to remote pilot the TARDIS away from Earth. Back in a tick. And you might want to find something to hang on to.
Okay. Pull the activation lever, and let's go.
Nicely done. We've landed on... Let me see... Metabilis 4. Ah well, it's better than Metabilis 3, but nowhere near as good as Metabilis 1 or 2. They were great. I told you I've been tracking down what was behind the reality virus. Well, now I know, and it's not good news. But if you're risking your life to help me, I think you deserve to know the truth. Emma, maybe you can generate some images to go along with what I'm telling you. Right then. Billions of millennia ago, when the universe was fragile and new, planets formed and stars began to burn. And at some point, no one really knows when, the very first sentient life form in all of creation was born. Or maybe I should say, she began to exist. The universe's first creature with conscious awareness was, by definition, all alone in the world. She spawned more of her own species, nurtured them. She was the very first mother. The cosmos expanded. Planets and stars became vast galaxies, and life spread throughout countless systems, throughout centuries. And that first sentient being, let's call her the First, while she slept for billions of years. But as the prototype for all consciousness, the First had design faults, teething problems, the most serious of which was very obvious. She didn't know how to die. When she was revived, she looked on in absolute horror at what her children had turned into. Their warfare and cruelty and brutality all appalled her. She felt duty-bound to right these wrongs. She was compelled to destroy her creations. To eradicate all sentient life, to return the universe to how it had been when she gazed across the first horizons. To atone. The First has evolved into a super intelligent but very damaged figure. She's experienced many forms over the years, but now, I believe, she's humanoid. She sees herself as simply escalating a process that species right across the universe are already hell-bent upon. She's nurturing conflict and chaos and destruction so she can end their plight and begin anew. She's not a god, and she's not evil. She wants redemption. She wants another chance. She wants children who love her and each other. And we, well, we have to stop her.
So that's who's behind the reality virus. That's who we're up against.
That's who we're up against. We're close, though. Get hold of the final time crystal and the TARDIS can get all three of them to me so I can get back to where I should be and, you know, save the universe. It's what I do best. I just want to warn you, though. The TARDIS has sensed the First is near. The danger's never been greater. Be careful.
Whoa, look at this place. Hey, I don't want to be that guy. That's it. Keep doing that. I think it's working. Good old son. It's the time crystal. Ah, I didn't think it'd be that easy. Right. I may have spoken too soon. Hey, at least it can't get any worse. Looks like that's it. Oh, what? That's a Dalek.
Scanning for duplicate. Scanning sensors indicate you are not a Dalek. You will be exterminated.
That's a Dalek.
Scanning!
This was meant to be
scanning!
That was a close one. Okay, I've tapped into the TARDIS database. And you know I said things couldn't get any worse?
Yeah, well, I was wrong.
Remember... another one! Let's do this same as before, okay? Slow and stealthy.
Possible diversion detected! I will investigate and exterminate any opposition! Commencing analysis. Possible dive. Unauthorized object detected. The human has escaped.
How many of these things are there?
The intruder must be found. Unsanctioned activity in scanning for the intruder.
Wow. That was intense. Can you imagine what it's like to be the doctor and do this kind of stuff all the time? For me personally, I'll take the TARDIS database over killer aliens any day of the week. Ha! Great minds really do think alike. Okay, I'm gonna control the movement because I'm pretty sure I'm a better driver than you. You take care of the shooty bits. And just so you don't freak, I've altered the power setting on the weaponry you'll be using. When you blast a Dalek, you're only taking out its casing. You're not actually killing the creature inside. Okay, let's go. Okay, let's do this.
The intruder must be eliminated!
Operative!
becomes impaired. The human is an effective warrior and must be destroyed.
We've got to go in and see what's happening. What the? What's going on? The TARDIS has been destroyed. We're too late. She's wiped out reality. Okay, we're in the inner temple of the First, and here she is. Don't try anything rash. She's unbelievably powerful.
Unbelievably powerful? You say it like it was a bad thing. Power, in the right hands, can be beautiful. And you don't have to worry about my omnipotence. After all, Mother knows best. I only wanted what was best for my children. Would you hold that against me? Could you hold that against any parent? The only difference is, I have the power to make my resolve become reality. I will give you a second chance. I will give all living creatures rebirth. And before that rebirth, I ask for only one thing. Your death. Universal annihilation in exchange for a brighter tomorrow.
Wow. Talk about tough love.
I love you all. Good night.
I'm gonna need your help more than ever now, because the universe is hanging by a thread. The reality virus has deleted the TARDIS interior and wiped out almost everything. But hey, I love a good almost. And right now, that almost says to me, you can still do this. You can fight it. You can come back. Because this time round, I found out very quickly that sometimes all it really needs is a leap of faith.
Of the living, are you? The doctor filled me in. Turns out she didn't need the Zyton. But she did need you to visit all those places to collect the time crystals, because she knew the first was watching her, and by extension, watching you.
Those locations were the last things in the first's memory, and so they're virtually the last snatches of reality to be destroyed. I've hidden three items, one in each of three environments.
The doctor disguised the items, but all of them has something unique about their physical appearance. A clue that suggests they're bound up with the first in some way.
I'll explain later, but when they're placed together, they'll form a device powerful enough to deal with the first. I hope. Because the universe is so fractured, to reach a location that still exists, you just have to visualize it. That's what you've got to do now. I can't help you, because the voice you're hearing now is a simple psychic projection while I keep the first busy.
First, you must remember the office from the London Laundrette. Let your memories guide us to where we need to go now. I'm losing you.
Annual connections drifting. Can you still hear me?
Great. And our neural connection is strengthening. Our optic connection is getting clearer. Start looking for... You got it. We need just one more piece, which means one more memory.
What? What do you think you're doing? Are you trying to interfere with my plans?
Ignore her. Just find the third object, and let's get out of here. You did it! We've got the final piece of the device. I'm gonna pull you back to the temple, so we can put the three pieces together. We're back! Oh! What happened? The objects. They're here. But what do we do now?
You're too late. Don't you see that? I'm redeeming my children, giving you all a second chance. Why would you fight against that? Happy Mother's Day.
I think we need some help. Doctor, what now?
My people, they reckoned the first might make it here someday. So they created a device powerful and ingenious enough to send her back to her beginning. It was too dangerous to leave lying about. So I split it into three and hid it. I knew the first would be watching me, so I needed you to make sure those locations were amongst the last to exist, and that you could get back to them. That was crucial. You had to know them really well. I've appealed to the first to let us continue to live our lives, offered her a truce. She refused. So now you have to send her back to the genesis of time using the device you've assembled. You've
hardly any time left.
I know what you've got to do. You've got to sonic the device.
When you see a sunset or flowers, remember my love for you. I only wanted what was best for my children. For you.
Well, I don't want you to get too big in your boots, but guess what? I reckon you just saved the universe. The first's been flung back to the beginning of time, but she's not dead. Without her, the virus ceased to exist and reality has snapped back into place. But because the first lives, she's effectively in a time loop. She will try time and time again to unleash the virus and wipe out all of sentient creation. Her threat will recur over and over. She will always return, which is why you must always be there to stop her. I'm taking you back to where it all started. The little laundrette in London. I'm sorry I misled you. I had to. I let the first kidnap me, and I had to let her think I was done for. I knew she might intercept some messages and knew she wouldn't be worried about you collecting Zyton. Why would she? She thought she was invincible. But all the time I was working with you. I only work with the best, and I knew you fitted the bill. I always know. And before you go, one more thing. Emma, I've downloaded her consciousness into a synthetic person. Someone you might recognise. Away from all this, she's living a happy life because of everything you did. And she is so grateful. We've landed. The TARDIS has brought us home. Recognise this place? Go on. Take a look. You're gonna have to do it all over again to save the universe. And steady. You'll feel disorientated for a second or two. That's because we've shorted out the time differential. But you'll be okay in a tick. Right. This is goodbye. For now. Just two more things. One, thank you. Really, thank you, thank you, thank you. For everything. And two, you remember Emma told you she'd always be your friend? Well,